Amyotrophic lateral sclerosis is a progressive, debilitating motor neuron disease that affects both upper and motor neurons. The disease affects corticospinal tract, starting from the motor cortex to the spinal cord.
What's the pathology of the amyotrophic lateral sclerosis? There is degeneration and death of the upper and lower motor neurons with accumulation of lipofuscin. The death of the upper motor neuron leads to the thinning of the corticospinal tract that travels in the anterior and lateral columns to the spinal cord. And death of the neurons in the lower motor neuron in the anterior horn cell and the corresponding brainstem homologous nuclei that supply the bulbar muscles leads to the degeneration and muscle atrophy. So what happens in the lateral and anterior corticospinal tract, that because of the death and degeneration, there is thinning of this tract and there is also proliferation of the microglial and astroglial cells as occur in the other degenerative processes. In the lateral column, there is thinning of the corticospinal tract that leads to loss of fibers in the lateral columns with fibrillary gliosis, known as lateral sclerosis. What remains normal? Sensory system remains normal. The muscle coordination remains normal. And the cognitive processes remains normal. And also the muscles that control the eye movement, they remain normal. And the parasympathetic neurons in the spinal cord also remains normal. Pathogenesis of ALS. It's due to the excessive activity of the glutamate. Glutamate is the most abundant excitatory neurotransmitter in the brain and it causes excitotoxic cell death.
Why glutamate causes cell death?
Glutamate causes excitotoxic cell death and it's due to the diminished activity of the glutamate transponders at the synaptic cleft, so that the excitotoxicity of the glutamate affects the postsynaptic neurons. Superoxide dismutase 1 detoxifies the free radical. The superoxide dismutase mutations becomes toxic to the motor neuron. Otherwise, they detoxify
free radicals. The excitotoxic reaction causes oxidative stress, and oxidative stress leads to the synthesis of free radical. Free radical is highly reactive and it takes up the nutrition of the other cell organelles. So it disrupts the function of mitochondria, endoplasmic reticulum, also of the nucleus. So there is impaired axonal transport. As a result of that, the cell die and the muscle atrophy.
The mutation in superoxide dismutase 1 is autosomal dominant.
Occurs in 20% of cases.
The familial form of the disease is due to mutation in chromosome 21.
Also, there are
long arms or chromosome 2, 9 and 15. ALS is a degenerative motor neuron disease. Initial features may be selective involvement only of the upper and lower motor neurons, but ultimately involves both upper and motor neurons. The lesions, both types, may be present even in one limb.
What are the features of upper motor neuron lesion? The features of upper motor neuron lesions are hypertonia, hyperreflexia, and spasticity. The Babinski sign is abnormal or positive. The spasticity is the hallmark of the upper motor neuron lesion. Spasticity is a state of sustained increase in muscle tension in response to muscle lengthening. Pseudobulbar palsy is the hallmark of the upper motor neuron disorder. And what's pseudobulbar effect syndrome? It's an inappropriate and involuntary laughing, crying and weeping. So what's Babinski sign, positive and negative? A negative Babinski sign is present in normal people and is plantar flexion of the toes. A positive Babinski sign is a feature of upper motor neuron lesion and there is fanning of the toes and the dorsiflexion of the big toe. What are the other features of the upper motor neuron lesion? The muscles affected in the limb are initially soft and floppy in upper motor neuron, but after a few days or weeks, the stretch reflexes recover, so the limbs become stiff.
So there is a spastic paralysis. The other feature is clasp-knife rigidity. On examination, there is considerable resistance to movement, which suddenly gives way and the limb can be moved freely. This is known as clasp-knife rigidity. And what's clonus? If the clinician suddenly flexes ankle, a sustained series of contractions of the flexor muscles can often be elicited. This is known as clonus.
What are the features of lower motor neuron lesions? There is flexor paralysis, muscle atrophy, hypotonia and hyporeflexia, fasciculations and fibrillations. The lower motor neuron affects the anterior horn cell of the spinal cord. So what are the other diseases that affects the anterior horn cell of the spinal cord? They are bulbospinal atrophy or Kennedy syndrome, spinal muscle atrophy, genetic metabolic diseases, and poliomyelitis. So poliomyelitis can cause lower motor neuron type of lesions. What are the other nerves that cause lower motor neuron lesions? The cranial nerve involvement causes lower motor neuron lesions. The cranial nerves involved are cranial nerve 5, 7, 9, 10, and 12, and they cause dysphagia, dysarthria, dysphonia, and choking. Hoarseness is due to the involvement of cranial nerve 10 or vagus. Which cranial nerves are not involved? The eye muscles are not involved, which are supplied by the 3rd, 4th and 6th cranial nerves. Also, in motor neuron disease, the bowel and bladder functions are normal until late in the disease.
So what's the difference between bulbar and pseudo-bulbar palsy? The bulbar palsy is a lower motor neuron disorder that affects the brain stem, whereas pseudo-bulbar palsy is an upper motor neuron disorder that affects both brain stem and spinal cord. The test done for the ALS are EMG, blood test, nerve conduction study, muscle biopsy, CT scan, MRI, and genetic or familial form, but none of them is diagnostic. So the diagnostic criteria is
definitive diagnosis involvement of three of the following four motor neuron regions is required: bulbar, cervical, thoracic, and lumbosacral.
So this is the criteria for ALS diagnosis: clinically definite diagnosis with upper and lower motor neuron findings in at least three body regions,
clinically probable upper and motor neuron findings in at least two body regions, and clinically possible upper motor and lower motor neuron findings in one body region. The most important differential diagnosis is that with the cervical compression due to spondylitic myelopathy or due to a tumor, both of which can cause upper and lower motor neuron features. The diagnosis is done by exclusion. There would be intact sensory system, normal CSF, normal X-ray spine, normal bladder and bowel function.